That's, you know, I believe his identity is in Winterfell. I believe he is a Stark. So, but the Jon's Council, once he becomes the king of Westeros, his truly right, Davos Seaworth will be his hand. Jorah Mormont will be the new Night Watch commander, and Samuel Tarly will be the Grand Maester of King's Landing. And Gendry Baratheon will be the Warden of the North as Arya Stark, or maybe Sansa Stark as his wife. One of those two women Starks, female Starks, Arya or Sansa will be the Lady of Winterfell as wife of Gendry. And then at the end, Bran becomes a Night King. So that is my prediction. That's my season 8 predictions. Now I want to hit you guys up. For another casting. I spoke about this with my coworker at work, and she's a big Game of Thrones fan. And I had a prediction. If they ever were to record the movie of Robert's Rebellion, or even do a series of Robert's Rebellion, and I had the pleasure of being the casting director for that, these are the people I would love to act as the main characters of the story of Robert's Rebellion. And I will start with this. I'm gonna start with Lyanna Stark. Ariana Grande should be Lyanna Stark. She's young, pretty. She has nice brunette hair. I believe she works for that role. Rickard Stark, Ned Stark's father. Russell Crowe, why not? He fits the part. He's older, brutish man. He fits the role with the beard and all that stuff. He fits that part. Young Eddard Stark. I was going back and forth on this choice, but I'm going to go with Theo James. Now, anybody who knows Theo James, he was in Underworld, Blood Wars, and Annihilation. I think he'd be a good choice for young Eddard Stark. Young Benjamin Stark would be Tom Holland, which is the current Spider-Man. You can't go wrong with that. And the Mad King, Aerys Targaryen. I was going back and forth between him and Kiefer Sutherland, but I'm gonna go with Liam Neeson as the Mad King. His voice just fits the whole burn them all and all that stuff. So I'm going to go with Liam Neeson for that. And Rhaegar Targaryen, the guy who should play him should be Alexander Skarsgård. Anybody who doesn't know Alexander Skarsgård is Eric from True Blood. Any True Blood fans? Yeah. He fits that part perfectly. That's his role. And the young Robert Baratheon, my main man, Gerard Butler. He should be Robert Baratheon. Young Robert Baratheon. He fits that part perfectly. And Rhaella Targaryen, the wife of Mad King, Nicole Kidman. And Tyrion Lannister will remain the same, with Charles Dance as Tyrion Lannister. Do some CGI, make him look a little younger. And also, Jaime Lannister will remain the same, with Nicola Costa Waldo. You know, like I said, CGI will make him a little younger. And now I get to Brandon Stark, Ned's older brother. I'm going to go with... I had two choices for this. I had two choices between Henry Cavill and Kiefer Sutherland. I'm going to go with Henry Cavill, Superman, as Brandon Stark. You know, he fits the mold a little bit better with the accent and the brunette hair. You know, Kiefer Sutherland could easily be either Brandon Stark or Mad King, but I'm gonna choose Henry Cavill. You guys can argue about it with me about that if you like. And also Ben Kingsley should be the Dornish King at that time of Robert's Rebellion, as the father of Elia Martell, Oberyn Martell. And now, the final main character of this story. You know, I didn't go into Arthur Dayne or Sir Barristan, but I'm going to go with this final character. I'm going to go with Elia Martell, Jessica Alba. She has the perfect skin complexion, the perfect brunette hair. Jessica Alba definitely fits the role of Elia Martell. You know? You guys can argue with me about that all you want, but this is, if I was the casting director, I would choose these particular actors for these particular characters for the Robert's Rebellion storyline. Truth be told, it will never happen because of one reason. About these people being casted as these characters, money. These actors are gonna ask for a high price for their services for this Robert's Rebellion, but if they were to do it, and these guys were willing to take a discount to do this, do the series on Robert's Rebellion, go for it. I think it'll just work perfectly in my eyes. It'll work perfectly. So, let me know what you think about this episode. Comment me, like my page on Facebook, True Players Podcast. Send me messages, comments, and feedback on the True Players Podcast webpage. I will definitely answer those comments on the next podcast for you. Like I said, definitely this is a change of pace of my episodes as we try to diversify my episodes on True Players Podcast, get into more relationships, politics. So we're still going to maintain the theme of sports, but also diversify my podcast to reach more audiences, which I promise you guys I will. I promise you guys I was going to talk more about relationships. I promise you guys I'm going to talk about more other things outside of sports. And once again, guys, thanks for listening to my podcast. Definitely hit up, you know, my main man Joey G on his radio station, Joey G Radio. My episodes will also be on his radio station. Also, you can catch my podcast on Spotify, Google Podcasts, and Apple Podcasts. And definitely, guys, I'm gonna sign off on this podcast. I'll talk to you guys soon with a new episode. In the end, I'll holler at you guys later. Listen to this Game of Thrones theme. Once again, I don't own the rights to this theme, to the theme of Game of Thrones, but definitely listen to it. Peace.
The podcast you just heard was made using Anchor. Ever thought about making your own podcast? Anchor makes it really easy for anyone to get started. It's a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing podcasts. Best of all, it's 100% free. Sign up now at anchor.fm/new. That's anchor.fm/new to get started.